Hello everybody and welcome to the Kreatryx YouTube channel. I welcome you all in a fresh session of analog electronics. And my dear friends, when I say we are going to learn analog electronics from the very basic, I mean it. We will be learning from the very, very basic level to the very advanced level along with a lots and lots of questions. So before we do that, let me first introduce myself for my friend who is meeting me for the first time. My dear friends, my name is Ankit Goyal. I got AIR1 twice in GATE in 2014 and 2018. I was awarded the President of India Gold Medal in the year 2013 when I graduated from IIT Indore. Till date, I have trained more than 1 lakh students in the online and the offline classes and presently working as a director at Unacademy for GATE department. But my dear friends, the reason behind this series is because of the huge demand of analog electronics and the belief that whenever you ask for anything, we are there to deliver. Yes, my dear friends, we are here for you. We are here delivering for you. And when we say it, we'll support you to the very, very fullest level. And this series will help you crack GATE with the top rank. It will enable ECE student to get 12 out of 12 and 5 out of 5 for electrical students. So my dear friends, if you want to learn with us live, then you can join Unacademy using the code Ankit ESE to get an immediate 10% discount. And not only my dear friend 10% discount, it also brings you under my guidance so that I can help you do something that I have done. I can at least take you near to this goal. Okay. So if you also dream the same thing, then join me in this journey on Unacademy subscription using the code Ankit ESE. Now, my dear friend, if you like the content that I deliver, you can watch more of my free videos on this URL, tinyurl.com/AnkitESE. Here you will find all my videos arranged subject-wise, chapter-wise, and you will find great content for free. And you are definitely going to love it. You are definitely going to enjoy. It not only includes conceptual videos, but it also includes problem-solving sessions. So just visit this once and you will fall in love with this URL. Don't forget it. It is a lifeline for you. And if you love the content that we are delivering on YouTube, we have created the first ever video book for you guys, where you will find all the videos along with all the notes that we provide arranged subject wise, chapter wise. So now, my dear friends, your dreams are no longer dreams. They are becoming a reality because you are getting a top quality course, well arranged, well structured, and that too for free. So what can be better than that? Nothing, my dear friends. So we have empowered the dreams of those who earlier used to think that only the person with a huge amount of money can crack GATE with a top rank. No, my dear friends, that is not the case. Even you can do it. But yes, just you need to believe in yourself and visit this link. But remember, this is a case sensitive link, so write this in uppercase. Other than that, if you join plus subscription, you get all the top educators like me teaching you live in daily lectures, along with providing you daily practice paper, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, crash course, rank improvement batch, and most importantly, clearing your each and every doubt. So if you join plus subscription, it is an entire world inside it. So you don't have to look outside. Once you enter plus, every need of yours will be taken care of and we will make your journey as smooth as possible towards that destination of getting under 100, under 10 rank. Believe me, my friend, you leave that strategy part to us. You leave the content part to us. You just work hard and we will make sure that you obtain the top rank in GATE and ESE. And Iconic is a big brother of Plus. Yes, this is a little brother. So Iconic gives you everything that the Plus subscription gives, along with much more. The major part of Iconic is this personal coach, a person dedicated to you on a daily basis to get you the top rank, guiding you, getting your schedule designed, making your strategy. Everything that you need to get the top rank is being done by this personal coach. He'll also create a study planner for you, which you can follow blindly and reach your destination with utmost ease. They will be analyzing your test result and tell you where you are lacking, how you can improve. So that way, my dear friend, everybody else will get a standard analysis, but you will get an analysis just tailor-made for you. Along with it, we have included study material additionally, theory and question bank, and soon we'll be introducing interview guidance into this. So this will become a complete package for a student who wants to take that journey from being an average student to sitting into a PSU or a M.Tech seat. So for them, this journey will be just like driving a Lamborghini to work. So that sort of a experience, that sort of a royal experience we are going to give you. So let's move on to the lecture. And if you want to join Unacademy, just make sure you use the code Ankit ESE to get my guidance as well as to get 10% over and above whatever Unacademy offers you. So now let's move on to the lecture, dear friends, and let's see what we have in store for you.
Hi guys, in the previous few lectures, what we have covered is, we have covered two type of oscillator, RC oscillator and LC oscillator. Now both these type of oscillators are called as harmonic oscillator because they generate sinusoidal oscillation. So in this video, we will be studying a different type of oscillator that is called as multivibrator, which is a relaxation oscillator and is used to generate waveforms such as square wave, triangular wave and so on. Now first thing first, what is the meaning of a multivibrator? Multivibrator is a device that oscillates or vibrates between two or more states. Okay, so that is, it is vibrating it between multiple states and that is why it is called as a multivibrator. Now multivibrator is basically divided into three categories. The first one is called as astable multivibrator. Astable means that it has no stable state. Suppose it has two states from digital, suppose 0 and 1. Then none of the state is stable, so it will keep on oscillating between the two states. It will go from 0 to 1 and then it will go from 1 to 0. So it will keep on oscillating between the two states. It will go by itself from one state to the other. It means it does not require any input signal. It will change its state on its own. You don't need to apply any sort of input signal. The second one is called as monostable multivibrator. It has one stable state. So let me take an example. Suppose 1 is stable and 0 is unstable. Then it will go from 0 to 1 by its own. But in order to send it from 1 to 0, you need to apply an input. So to go from stable to unstable state, you will need an input signal. But to go from unstable to stable state, we don't need any input signal, and that is called as monostable multivibrator. The third one is called as bistable multivibrator. That means it has two stable states, that is both the states are stable. So to go from 0 to 1 also you need to apply an input, and to go from 1 to 0 also you need to apply an input. That means our stable multivibrator does not need any input. Monostable needs input for one transition but does not need any input for the other transition, and bistable needs the input signal for both the transition from low to high as well as from high to low. It needs input signal for both the transition. Now we will first talk about Schmitt trigger. Schmitt trigger is also called as bistable multivibrator. Now what is Schmitt trigger actually? It is op amp in positive feedback configuration which will work as bistable multivibrator. Bistable means you will need to apply an input in order to change the state of the multivibrator. In order to send it from low to high or from high to low, in both the cases you will need to apply the input. Now how we will show the feedback? The feedback must be from at the positive terminal, because we are using positive feedback. That is RF and R1. Okay, that is called as your Schmitt trigger, in which we are feeding the output back to the non-inverting terminal of the input, or we are applying positive feedback. Now Schmitt trigger are basically divided into two categories: inverting Schmitt trigger and the second one, non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Inverting Schmitt trigger means input is applied at the inverting terminal. Non-inverting Schmitt trigger means input is applied at the non-inverting terminal. Okay, so it depends where you are applying the input signal. That way you can call the Schmitt trigger either as inverting or as non-inverting. So let us first start with the inverting Schmitt trigger. See, in inverting Schmitt trigger, I have applied the input signal at the inverting terminal and the non-inverting terminal is grounded, and we are connecting the feedback at the non-inverting terminal. Now first thing first, the current at the input terminal is 0 ampere. Okay, that means these two are in series. The voltage of this terminal is V reference. So what is V reference? It is V naught. I am applying potential division, R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, now what you need to do in such kind of application of Schmitt trigger, how do you analyze this? You first assume case 1, assume that V0 is plus Vset. In negative feedback only V0 does not saturate, but in positive feedback the gain will increase, because in positive feedback what is the gain? A upon 1 minus A beta. If the gain is very high, then op amp will saturate. So output can only have two values, either Vset or minus Vset. Remember this thing, in positive feedback the output always saturates. So we can only have two values, either plus Vset or minus Vset. So case 1, I am assuming that output is plus Vset. In that case, what is V reference? Vset into R2 by R1 plus R2. That is the reference voltage. Now see, what is the voltage of negative terminal? It is input voltage. If positive terminal voltage is greater than negative terminal voltage, then by means of comparator you can say V0 is Vset. That means Vset R2 by R1 plus R2 is greater than Vin, or let me call it as Vin less than beta Vset. This is actually V reference is the feedback voltage. What is the ratio of feedback voltage and the output voltage? The ratio of feedback and output voltage is beta, which is here R2 by R1 plus R2. So I am calling it as beta. If Vin is less than beta Vset, output remains at Vset. Now take the second case. If V negative is greater than V positive, voltage of inverting terminal is more than non-inverting terminal, V0 is minus Vset. So negative terminal voltage is Vin is greater than positive terminal voltage, which is beta Vset, then V0 becomes minus Vset. So I will say as Vin goes above beta Vset, V0 switches from VSAT to minus VSAT. So output will switch from plus V saturation to minus V saturation if you increase the input voltage above beta VSAT. So this beta VSAT is called as UTP or upper triggering point. That is the triggering voltage, that is the level of input voltage above which the output will switch. So triggering point is the level of the input voltage at which output will switch. Let us see case number 2. Case 2. Assume V naught equal to minus VSAT. If V naught is minus VSAT, V reference, which is V naught R2 by R1 plus R2, will become minus VSAT R2 by R1 plus R2. This factor R2 by R1 plus R2 I called as beta. So minus beta VSAT. Now, if this negative terminal voltage is less than positive terminal voltage, V0 will remain as minus VSAT. Because whenever negative terminal voltage is less, V0 is minus VSAT. So V negative is V in is less than minus beta VSAT, then output remains as minus VSAT. But if negative terminal voltage is greater than positive terminal voltage, that is V in is greater than beta minus beta VSAT, the output becomes VSAT. So V naught switches from minus VSAT to VSAT. Okay. So if input goes above minus beta VSAT, then output will switch from minus VSAT to plus VSAT. So if I want to draw it on a curve, or if I want to draw the transfer characteristic, then I want to have a curve between V0 and Vin. This minus beta VSAT in our case is called as LTP, lower triggering point. That is the triggering voltage at which output will change, but it is less than beta VSAT, so it is lower triggering point. Beta VSAT is higher, so it is upper triggering point. So this beta VSAT is actually the limit for Vin. So on the axis of Vin, I will show two voltages. One voltage will be UTP. Other voltage will be LTP. But V0 can have two levels, VSAT and minus VSAT. So what we said earlier, if Vin goes above beta VSAT or UTP, then output will go from VSAT to minus VSAT. If input goes above UTP, the output will go from VSAT to minus VSAT. If it tries to go above UTP. Okay. And we said if input goes below. Actually these conditions are opposite. If input goes below minus beta VSAT. If input goes below minus beta VSAT, output will switch from minus to plus. So it will go like this. It will switch from minus to plus if input goes below LTP. So we show the curve like this. Okay. Now, additionally, what we have to do is, see, if input stays below minus beta VSAT, output will remain at minus VSAT. So, if input goes below LTP, the output will remain at minus VSAT. Sorry, if it stays above. If it stays above minus beta VSAT, if input is more than minus beta VSAT, if input is more than minus beta VSAT, V0 remains minus VSAT. So, LTP is minus beta VSAT. So, So what I am saying, if input is more than minus beta Vsat, output will remain at minus Vsat. So we will show like this. That means if input is above LTP, the output will remain at minus Vsat. Same way, see here. If input stays below beta Vsat, then output remains at Vsat. If input stays up below beta Vsat, this is beta Vsat. If input lies to the left, then output will remain at Vsat, like this. So it means if you try to go above UTP, output will switch from plus to minus. If you try to go below LTP, it will switch from minus to plus. This is called as hysteresis curve. And this width is called as hysteresis width. And this width is 2 beta Vsat. Okay. Hysteresis width is the 2 beta Vsat, which is the difference between UTP and LTP. Same way, if I go by waveform, suppose I have a sinusoidal signal like this, and we have two triggering points. One is UTP and the other is LTP. So what we know about the output? If input goes above UTP, if input goes above UTP, output will go from Vsat to minus Vsat. So here input goes above UTP, output goes from minus Vsat to plus Vsat to minus Vsat. Then we say, if input goes below minus beta Vsat is this. If input goes below minus beta Vsat, output will go from minus to plus. If input goes below minus beta Vsat, output will go from minus to plus. Then if input goes above UTP, output will go from plus to minus. Then below LTP, minus to plus. So that will be the waveform of V0. If you try and go above UTP, then output will switch. And if you try to go below LTP, then also output will switch. That means in order to switch from plus Vsat to minus Vsat or from minus Vsat to plus Vsat, you need to change the input signal. Now suppose I modified the inverting Schmitt trigger like I am drawing now. In inverting Schmitt trigger, at the inverting terminal we have input. At non-inverting terminal, we have R1, R2, and instead of grounding, we are applying a reference voltage Vref. Okay, I have not grounded the positive terminal. Now what happens if you want to find the voltage of the positive terminal, then V plus is determined by superposition. How to determine V plus by superposition? First of all, ground this V reference. Then V positive will be V naught. These two will be in series always. There is no current here. It will be V naught R2 by R1 plus R2. Then in the next case, in order to apply superposition, take V reference here and ground V0. Then V positive will be the voltage across R1, because we have to observe this voltage with respect to ground. Now R1 is connected between V positive and ground. So if you again apply voltage division, you will say V reference R1 over R1 plus R2. That is the voltage of positive terminal. Now what you have to do, in order to find UTP and LTP, you have to assume V0 first as Vset. In that case, the positive terminal voltage is Vset R2 over R1 plus R2 plus Vref R1 over R1 plus R2, and negative terminal voltage is Vin. So what I will say, if negative terminal voltage is greater than positive terminal voltage, V0 will become minus Vset. That means if input voltage is greater than Vset R2 by R1 plus R2 plus Vref R1 by R1 plus R2, then output will switch from plus Vset to minus Vset. R2 by R1 plus R2 we called as beta. So beta Vset plus V reference R1 by R1 plus R2. I will call it as UTP. Similarly, now if you assume V0 as minus Vset, then positive terminal voltage will be, this term is beta, minus beta Vset plus V reference R1 by R1 plus R2. Now you will say, if negative terminal voltage Vin, if negative terminal voltage Vin is less than positive terminal voltage, then V0 will switch to Vset. So this voltage will be called as LTP. So now we have find out UTP and LTP. Earlier UTP was beta Vset, LTP was minus beta Vset. Now both have a term in addition, which is V reference R1 by R1 plus R2, which means if you draw the transfer characteristic, both UTP and LTP have an additional term, which is V reference into R1 by R1 plus R2. That means if both have certain additional term, both will be shifted to the right. Okay. So this will be your UTP, this will be your LTP. But if you find out UTP minus LTP, which is called as hysteresis width, UTP minus LTP will be same as 2 beta Vset, because this term of V reference will get cancelled. So hysteresis width remains same, but by applying reference voltage, what happens? The curve will shift either to the right or to the left depending upon polarity of the reference voltage. Are you getting my point? So what happens if we apply reference voltage? We can shift the hysteresis curve to right or left depending upon polarity of reference voltage. Next category of Schmitt trigger is the non-inverting Schmitt trigger. Now see that inverting terminal is grounded and non-inverting terminal is connected to Vin. So now what will happen, how we will analyze this circuit? We have to find the positive terminal voltage. Now again there are two sources, so we will apply superposition. Find V positive by superposition. So first, make V0 equal to 0. Okay, if you make V0 equal to 0, then what will be the value of V plus? It will be V in, and we will consider then the voltage across R1, because we always need to find the voltage of this node with respect to ground. So which terminal are you grounding? V0. So if you are grounding V0, you will find the voltage across R1, R1 over R1 plus R2. Secondly, you will make V in equal to 0. If you ground this terminal, then you will take voltage across R2. So it is V naught R2 by R1 plus R2. By superposition, what I can say, V positive is V in into R1 over R1 plus R2 plus V naught R2 over R1 plus R2. Okay. Now, what will happen is, again, if you want to analyze this circuit, what you have to do, first let me simplify this expression. I will say R2 over R1 plus R2. 1 minute. R1 we will take common. So it will be V in plus R2 by R1 V0. Now I told you, whenever you are analyzing a Schmidt trigger, what you have to do, you have to assume two cases. One in which V0 is plus V set, and the other in which V0 is minus V set. So case 1, V0 is V set. In that case, what is the positive terminal voltage? R1 by R1 plus R2 V in plus R2 by R1 V set. This R2 by R1 V set I will call as beta V set. But remember, in both the circuits the value of beta is different. Earlier it was R2 by R1 plus R2, now it is R2 by R1. Okay. Now, the voltage of negative terminal is directly 0, it is grounded. So what you will say? If V positive is greater than V negative, output will remain at V set. That is V in plus beta V set greater than 0, or V in greater than minus beta V set, then V naught is V set. But if positive terminal voltage is less than negative, output will switch. What is positive terminal voltage? V in plus beta V set is less than 0. So V in is less than minus beta V set. In that case, output switches. So this voltage will be called as LTP. So if input goes below LTP, the output will switch from plus V set to minus V set. Okay. Now, if you take case number 2, V naught as minus V set, then what is V positive? It is R1 by R1 plus R2 V in minus beta V set. Again take, if V positive is greater than V negative, then V naught will become V set. What is V positive? V in minus beta V set is greater than 0, or you can say V in greater than beta V set. So this will be called as UTP. In that case, V naught will switch from minus V set to plus V set. But if positive terminal voltage is less than negative, V in minus beta V set is less than 0, or you can say V in is less than beta V set, then output will remain at minus V set. So if you try to go above UTP, output will go from minus to plus. If you try to go below LTP, then output will go from plus to minus. So if you try and draw the transfer characteristics, so on y-axis we have two points. What are the two points? V set and minus V set. And on x axis we have two points, UTP and LTP. So what we have seen, if we try to go above UTP, if you go above UTP, output will go from minus V set to plus V set. So above UTP, output will go from minus V set to plus V set. and below LTP it will go from plus VSAT to minus VSAT. So if you complete the curve, it will come in anti-clockwise direction like this. But if you see, if we stay below UTP, if we stay below UTP, output remains at minus VSAT. If we stay below UTP, output will remain at minus VSAT. Or if we stay above LTP, output will remain at VSAT. So that is the complete hysteresis curve. And again, the width, this hysteresis width is 2 beta VSAT. But in our case, beta is how much? It is R2 by R1. So beta changes in both the cases, but what also changes is the orientation of curve. In inverting Schmitt trigger, the curve was clockwise. In non-inverting Schmitt trigger, the curve is counter clockwise. Okay. So if I summarize what we have covered in this video, I have told you about the different types of multivibrators, that there are three categories: astable, monostable, bistable. Then we have seen Schmitt trigger, that it is of two categories: inverting and non-inverting. Here the LTP was minus beta VSAT, UTP was beta VSAT, where beta was how much? R2 over R1 plus R2. In non-inverting, beta became R2 by R1, but the concept remained the same. And I defined that the hysteresis width is the difference between UTP and LTP. And also I gave one more thing, that in inverting Schmitt trigger, the hysteresis curve is clockwise, whereas in non-inverting it is counterclockwise. Okay, so that is all about Schmitt trigger. So how you have to analyze? Just find out the voltage of both the input terminals of op-amp and compare the voltages in order to find the output. So that is how we analyze the Schmitt trigger. Okay, so in the next lecture I will show you application of Schmitt trigger, but this is all about the Schmitt trigger. Thank you.
I hope all of you have enjoyed the lecture that we were providing and all of you learned something very, very good. Now is the time to learn about the Unacademy subscription. So as I told the benefits of the Plus subscription at the very beginning, let's go through them very, very quickly. Live classes you get by the top educators, crash course, rank improvement badge, doubt clearing, weekly quiz, test series, previous year question, practice question, everything in one subscription called as Unacademy Plus. And iconic is one level higher. It provides you a personal coach who will mentor you on a daily basis, who will guide you on a daily basis, along with providing you study planner, test analysis, study material, and soon enough interview guidance. So if you are looking to join Unacademy, let's see what are the pricing. So my dear friends, before we see the pricing, just see the link. This link will help you crack GATE and ESE with the top rank, because we have created the first ever video book for GATE and ESE for my YouTube family, and you will get the notes as well as the lectures here. Just make sure that you write this link in the uppercase and you will get to the first ever video book for GATE and ESE, and it is nothing but revolutionary. Now let's see the pricing of Plus subscription. So for 12 months, the pricing is 3250, but if you apply the code ANKITESE, it becomes 27225. For 18 months, it will be 34650, and for 24 months, 39600. Believe me, my dear friend, this is the most affordable pricing, and the longer duration subscriptions are more cost effective as compared to shorter duration. Like here, it will cost you 1650 per month. Okay, this will be 2000 per month approx. This will be around 2250 per month. Then if you go for iconic for 12 months, it is 5250 with code Ankit ESE, it becomes 45225. And 2 year subscription becomes 66600. So the choice is your, but take a longer duration subscription for more cost effective solution and to give GATE and ESE at least two times, so that if you once crack GATE, in the next attempt you can even get ESE. And other than that, my friends, you can download the Unacademy learning app right now, because there we provide live classes for free, test series and live quizzes for free. And once you download it, make sure that you follow this profile. This is my profile, so that whenever I come live, you will get the notification. And this is the Telegram channel for our team. Here you will find all the lecture links, all the lecture files, and all the links for the special classes. Other than that, we have other YouTube channels like Mechanical, Civil, and Telugu. JE channel, Computer Science, Gate Question, and Electrical Junction, Parthshala, and GS Terminal. Electrical Junction contains short videos of great concepts. Parthshala provides you animated content. JE preparation can be done through these two channels, Unacademy SSC JE and GS Terminal. And you can refer the other channels to the other friends in respective branches, so that they can also be benefited. At last, I would like to say, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to this channel, and not only subscribe, press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever a new video comes. And share this videos among all your college group, among all your friends, so that we can create the first ever revolution of free education in field of GATE and ESE. Thank you to everybody for dedicating time to watching this video. Please move on to the next one as well, and take the benefit of all the free content that we are providing. And in case you have completed the series, do make sure you watch the other subjects available on this channel. Thank you.